Hello, and welcome to my review of Star Number 3, an issue that is written by Kelly Thompson with art by Javier Pina. And I like Star. I've liked the series. I like Star when she first came about in the Captain Marvel run of Kelly Thompson. The problem is, I was wondering when this book was announced, how are they going to pull this off? Star is a bit unhinged. She is not exactly a hero. She's getting very close to being a villain, if not already, and has a reality stone, which makes it very dangerous for somebody who is not exactly, 100% hero. She has some victims. This is pointed out by Carol in this issue. And one of the things that we've seen in these three issues, including this one, you end up where Ripley is starting to get a little more in touch with the reality stone. Her powers are growing. She's starting to figure out things, if not just being reactionary and her emotions taking over as well, where the reality stone is, something big. And you don't want to have that with somebody who you're not sure is a hero or a villain. And through these first two issues leading into this one, you end up having a bunch of guest stars. You end up having Carol. Captain Marvel, of course. You also end up having Scarlet Witch. You had Loki in the first issue. Also had the Black Order that are on their tail. Jessica Jones. A lot of guest stars, which I really like. That does continue a bit, though. It's not really new guest stars in this issue, but one in particular that we'll talk about in just a little bit. I really, really like the way that she is played in this issue. But the whole thing is about Ripley Ryan Star, and what happened going into this is her and Scarlet Witch trying to figure things out, kind of in a mindscape deal, that were attacked by a dragon. She realizes, oh no, was the dragon me? Am I my own worst enemy? And it reminds me, and this whole series so far does remind me a lot of Star Wars, where this bit of realization does remind me of Luke Skywalker on Dagobah, goes into the tree, fights what he thinks is Darth Vader, the mask explodes, and Luke is inside. Oh my, that's what it reminded me of there. But the whole thing with Scarlet Witch here is trying to get the trust of Ripley, trying to say, I know what you're going through. I understand. We got to figure this out. There is a path to redemption. You just have to be down with it. But let's try to figure out all that is going on. Ripley doesn't quite believe that anybody wants to help her. She doesn't think that anybody wants to help, and especially why should she trust Scarlet Witch? Well, Scarlet Witch does have a little bit of redemption deal in her past as well. So it's something that she must see in Ripley and, wants to help her out. But Ripley is still wondering, what is my future? What am I going to become, with this reality stone and with these powers and the idea that maybe I am a villain, a god, a devil? Am I a living nightmare? Kind of like Luke in the tree in Dagobah. And just the whole idea of redemption does remind me as well as Darth Vader, Anakin's big story as well. So very Star Wars-esque to me. And while Scarlet Witch is there to try to help Star into a bit of a redemption story, Carol, Captain Marvel, she doesn't want to go for that. She has seen Star end up having victims. She ends up thinking that Star is straight up villain. She wants to stop her. And this is the thing going into this book. Again, you have a book where the lead character isn't quite a hero yet. So you're hoping for this redemption. I don't know how you'll get it. She does have a reality stone, though, so we'll see with that. But yeah, you end up with Carol saying she almost, destroyed half of New York City. You're a little late for redemption. This is going to be bad. It's going to turn out bad. And she is getting better with her powers. So, what's going on? Is this good or bad for us with these powers? And they don't know. And this is something they're trying to figure out. But so is Star, because she ended up winking out when Carol went to punch her, ends up in her apartment, and she doesn't like what's happening to her. She's not somebody who is really down with all of this, and you do get a bit of a history lesson, a little recap, which I thought was odd in the third issue, going and telling you how she ended up becoming Star, the whole thing that happened when Nuclear Man attacked and they were in the bubble in New York City. If you haven't read it, it's the very beginning of the Captain Marvel series and then carries on. And I liked the story. I liked the whole idea of how she came about. She pretty much blames Captain Marvel for everything. While all this is going on, all hell is breaking loose. There's Captain Marvel being the hero, but not really saving everyone. And as she says, she just brought chaos. And that's when she ended up becoming Star. And she is a little triggered at Captain Marvel. Captain Marvel's triggered at her. She has a reality stuff. There's a lot going on and a lot that could lead to a big bunch of trouble, but she just wants to try to get out of this, but she realizes, I really can't. And that's where she ends up going pretty much Star Nuclear, ends up blowing up things. And this is the signal then for Black Swan to see. Black Swan and Black Dwarf of the Black Order, they're after Star. They're trying to find, obviously, the Reality Stone, because that's what they're all about. But that's what I like about this issue, that my favorite part of the issue is actually Black Swan in the issue, not Star, not Captain Marvel, not Scarlet Witch. It's Black Swan, who ends up seeing pretty much, she says, it's a beacon. It's pretty much saying, here I am, come and get me. And like, all right, and she's going to have to go. But they're worried about who else might be seeing that. Well, while this is going on, you do go to Captain Marvel, Jessica, and Scarlet Witch, still trying to figure out what redemption would be for Star. What is the plan if we get her? Is she going to go to prison for a little? Would she accept that? All of these things. Now, in the background there, you see hard-drinking Jessica Jones. She has been mind-controlled by Star to be worried about everybody who is after Star and that stone. And it continues on. It's pretty funny where they're all talking. Carol and Scarlet Witch are talking. Wanda talking. And like, what do you think, Jess? And like, I just have to find out who's after Star. And they realize, yeah, we gotta zap her out of this mind control, which Scarlet Witch does. But like I said, my big thing in this was the Black Swan stuff. She goes to Black Dwarf and pretty much says, kind of sick of these stones, and this is all they're about. And I think that this is kind of Kelly Thompson even saying, like, you know, every time the Black Order shows up and every time Black Swan, Black Dwarf, you know, all in Proxima, all they end up, all they're concerned about Thanos and the stones. She's getting sick of it. She wants to have her own life. She's like, I'm sick of these stones leading me everywhere and having to go deal with them. I'm kind of sick of it. Black Dwarf seems like he might be too, but he's not saying anything, and I worry about him. I worry about him going off and telling the rest of the Black Order, yeah, Black Swan ain't down with it anymore. But she goes then to do her duty, you think. She goes to Star. They start attacking. You end up, because of Star, having these abilities that are starting to manifest even greater. You see it here where Black Swan shoots the laser eyes and Star deflects them, ends up making an axe, and then even takes those abilities of Black Swan and uses them against her as they fight. And they continue to fight, and it's a decent enough fight. But the big thing is, even with the Reality Stone, Star is not as big and powerful as Black Swan, and she does end up being able to, you know, grab her, pin her down. And this is where the twist is, where she's like, listen, I'm not trying to hurt you here. We already saw, she's like, I'm sick of these stones. So here she says, I'm going to give you this device. And I can only think she puts it in her mouth, because I don't think we ever see where she does put it. But I'm going to give you this device. I know you're going to be skeptical about this, but you're going to thank me later. Also, use the Reality Stone to teach you how to speak Swedish. And don't ask me why. Maybe that it's Black Swan wants to come back and have some Swedish meatballs. We will see. I doubt that's it. But she says, you will thank me later for all of this. Now I'm just going to leave you. And she does leave her just in time for Captain Marvel to show up and, you know, looks pretty pissed off, trying to figure out what's going to go on. Also with this, she is in the wreckage of her building. So again, it looks as if Star is just destroying things again. So you end up having Captain Marvel come pretty triggered. And, you know, we'll see how that works out when we eventually get back to the books. But I like this issue. I didn't like it as much as the first two. The first two I liked a lot more. It felt real fresh with the different bunch of guest stars and characters. This one was a little bit of a recap from number two, then a little bit of an origin recap. So until you get to the halfway point, and really I think that's why the Black Swan stuff really got me, because that's where the book starts hitting, and then you only have a couple more pages till the end, though I still will give it a 7.5. I'm not fully sold on Javier Pino's art just yet. I wish that it was a little more brighter, but again, you're doing a lot of things at night. You're doing a lot of things like that, but I kind of wish I wish it popped more, but that's just me. But yeah, 7.5 out of 10. I think it is a book to give a look-see if you're sitting around and you don't have anything to read because of new comics not coming out. I think that it's well worth even go back to the Captain Marvel. I know that a lot of people on this here YouTube yell and scream about Star or Captain Marvel. I'm not going to be one of them because I like both books and both characters. So that's that. And thanks for watching. Thanks for watching all the videos. And if you like this video, like it below. Also, subscribe to the channel. And then look in the description of this and all the videos for all sorts of links to our podcasts and websites, both Marvel and DC. Everything still carries on. No new books doesn't mean things aren't going on. So check all that stuff out. And I'll talk to you later.